Hello everyone and welcome. When we talk about a masterpiece in the two-wheeler sector, it's clear that one of the best innovative manufacturer is Honda. Because as we all know, Honda has always made a significant impact in the world with its latest engines. Starting from its early days in the 1950s with its chimney engine, even until 2005. Actually, until now, although less exciting than its innovations in the past. But even so, here we want to discuss one of Honda's best years of innovation that will surely be interesting for you to follow until the end. It was precisely in 1992. Honda once created a motorcycle with a unique design called an R750, one of the legendary motorcycles still discussed today. The originally appearance of the Honda NR750 originated from the Honda NR500, created as a vehicles for competing in the World GP races. And here is the beginning of the uniqueness of the NR500. While other manufacturers then used successful 2-stroke 500cc engines, Honda remained loyal to its 4-stroke 500cc engine. Indeed, this condition would make it difficult for Honda to compete. Realizing this and the challenges Honda faced, the R&D team was forced to make unusual breakthrough with oval-shaped pistons by combining two pistons. Can you imagine how people reacted to this crazy idea from Honda? How could they come up with such quirky and utterly unconventional idea?
Oh my!
In fact, before developing the oval piston, Honda conducted experiment using an 8-cylinder engine with a capacity of 500cc. This engine was tested during practice sessions and achieved results that were considered quite satisfying. However, due to regulation that limited the number of cylinders to only 4 pistons, Honda closed that project and switched to developing the oval piston engine. Okay, let's get back to discussing the oval piston. It's not just the unusual shape, but the number of valves is also extraordinary. With these wider pistons, each piston has 8 valves in each cylinder, consisting of 4 intake and 4 exhaust valves, and 2 piston rods. Naturally, regular material wouldn't be strong enough to withstand the power produced by the engine. That's why every material used in this motorcycle is highly premium. For example, the pistons are made from duralium and magnesium. At the same time, titanium is used for the piston rods and valves, and also comes with a dual radiator made of aluminum. So when you add it all up, this engine features 4 oval pistons, 32 valves, 8 spark plugs, 8 piston rods, and 8 intake and exhaust ports. Isn't it fascinating? The configuration of this engine is truly the wild imagination of engineers brought to life. Now, let's move on to the layout. These pistons are arranged in a V4 configuration at 90 degrees. Equipped with DOHC valves, with piston size at 101.2mm, multiply 50.6mm, plus stroke length of 42mm. Indeed, all these factors make this engine unique and something we won't find in other manufacturers' bikes, right? Moving on to the body section. The bodywork is maximized using carbon fiber material to perfect this unique engine and minimize the additional weight from components like the cylinder head, large radiator, and other mentioned earlier. It's worth noting that during that time, carbon fiber technology was still very premium, advanced, and rare. Okay, now let's talk about power. This motorcycle has decent power that can compete with 2-stroke engines. But as a note, it's decent, not highly competitive, let alone dominant. It reached 125 horsepower at 14,000 RPM, and to enhance its performance, the redline of this engine is pushed to an incredibly insane point, just like the uniqueness of its piston shape, up to 23,000 RPM. At this point, Honda knows how to create a masterpiece and never hold back on its total commitment. This is what makes this engine truly appreciated by automotive enthusiasts until now. Additionally, the motorcycle has a torque of 66 Nm at 11,000 RPMs. However, regarding weight, this bike has a considerable heft, precisely around 244 kg. Yes, it's indeed heavy, but this is a risk that Honda had to take due to its complexity, ranging from the crankshaft to the cylinder head. Nevertheless, despite its weight, the powerhouse of an engine can still achieve a relatively fast top speed of 257 km per hour. Okay, let's continue exploring other aspects. On the other side, this motorcycle used suspension from the renowned suspension manufacturer Showa. The front suspension features a 45mm upside-down aluminum fork. At the same time, the swing arm is a monoshock type also made of aluminum. Honda equipped this motorcycle with a twin spar aluminum alloy beam frame wrapped in scratch resistant titanium to minimize weight. Moving on to its wheels. The bike is equipped with aluminum alloy wheels and Michelin TX radial tires, adding to its exclusivity. It's no wonder many people liken this motorcycle to the Ferrari of the two-wheel world. However, the fate of this motorcycle is quite unfortunate. It had to compete against two-stroke motorcycle, which clearly put it at a disadvantage compared to its four-stroke engine. As a result, this motorcycle ended up being a creation without experiencing the pinnacle of Honda's victory. When Honda realized the challenges of competing with the oval piston engine, they decided to sell it en masse as an exclusive motorcycle. And that's how the NR750 was born and mass produced. This motorcycle was produced in a limited quantity of only 300 units, priced at $5,000 during its release. Nevertheless, this motorcycle deserves appreciation. Honda dared to come forward affirming that the creativity, genius, and madness of Honda engineer in the two-wheeler sector should not be underestimated. They brought out the essence of four-stroke engines and created a motorcycle with quality and love that should not be taken lightly. Okay, that's all information we can provide in this video. If you have any suggestion, critics, or question, don't hesitate to discuss them in the comment section below. See you in the following video, and thanks for watching.